Mother the Virgin Mary, we may obtain the joys of everlasting life, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. In gloria pro terra Dei, et in quelli edificati un tutto mea. Iurica me Dei, seducio ne casa membri certe non santa, ma nomine bene quando lo sono per me. Quei tu sei un sfortitum me, quale ne pellissi, quali fissi in cielo, in ufficio per me. Et elogiam tuum veritate, et unissim et in un servum, et in un servum di montum sancti come di tabernacola tua, et in tuoi monetari dei denti di figali di tutti me. Confite in tutti vincitere, Deus, Deus me, per tristis anima me, al cuore tu povas me. Speri Deus, poni me, tocco di Deus, di salutare mutus me, et Deus meus. Gloria, Patria, Filio, et Spiritus Sancto, sic erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. In tuoi monetari dei denti di figali di tutti me. Auditorium nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci cielum et terra. Confiti ad omnipotenti via demonia sanctiti, di aiuta alla cancro, via tuoi battisti, sancti quasi spermi, parolino di tua Maria, via, omnibus santissimum vis vafes, quae peccavi di mis cogitazione per la domine, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ed eo prego beata Maria, se mi dice, via tu mi pare ma cancro, via tu mi battista, sancti quasi spermi, parolino. Veatum nuorum Mariam filiatum et sanctus opus fates, ora li promendo mandera nostra. Miseria putum in exterius sedis, et patis vis putifete, et vita materna. Amen. Confitio Deo omnipotenti, beate Maria sempre vigili, beate Michaeli arcangelo, beate Ioanni Battiste, sanctis apostolis Petro et Paolo, omnibus sanctis et in parte. Qui è peccato in inis cogitazione, verbo et opere. Mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ed eo preco beata Mariam Sempigena, beatum Michaelum Arcangelum, beatum Ioannem Baptistam, sanctus apostolos Petrum et Paulum, omnes sanctos, et Dei Pater, gloriae Domine, ad Dominum Deum nostrum. Miseriatum est omnipotens Deus, et missis peccatis vestris producat vos et vitam aeterna.
Amen.
Et urgentiam assumptionem et remissionem peccatorum solum tribuat nobis omnipotens misericordiae.
Amen.
Deus tu conversus vivificabis nos.
Et benedicit veritabitur in te.
Hos tendi nobis vobis libaniam tua.
Et salutare tua da nobis.
Domine exaudi rationem mea.
Et clamor meus ad te venia.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spirito tuo.
Ora benedictus. Sacerdotes tui Domini in tua justitia, et sancti tui exulte, et propte David servum tuum non avertas faciem Christi tui. Alleluia, alleluia. Memento Domine David et omnis mansuetudinis eius.
Gloria.
Gloria, Patria et Filio et Spiritus Sancto, sic erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Sacerdotis tui Domini in tua justitia, et sancti tui exulte, propte David servum tuum non avertas faciem Christi tui. Alleluia, alleluia. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo,
et in terra pax hominibus bone voluntatis,
laudamus te, benedicimus te. per l'olio Seius medita et audia transire perennia. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum Filium Tuum, qui tegum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Ordinemus. Exaudi nos Deus salutaris nostre, ut sicut e beate pudentia, veginis tui festivitati dademus, ita pie devotionis eludiamur effectu. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum Filium Tuum, qui tegum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Lex Epistolae Beatificarum posse et brevius. Frates, plures facti sunt sacerdotes, id circu quod morte proliberentur de venere. Iesus, autem, eo, quod mane atile eternum, sed eternum habet sacerdotium. Undi et salvarium perpetuum potes accedentes peseret ipsum aeterum, semper vivens et intervallandum pro nobis. Tale sede decebat ut nobis esse pontifex, sanctus, innocens, impolutus, segregatus, appetitorbus, et excelsio caelis factus. Qui non habet necessitatem quotidie, quem ad modum sacerdotes, prius possuis delictis hostias offere deiende pro populi, hoc enim fecit senus ipsum inferendo, Iesus Christus Dominus nostre.
Deo gratias.
Alleluia, alleluia. Iur ravi Dominus et non penetebit eum, tu desse scedus in eternum, secund ordinem Melchisedec. Alleluia. Amavit eum Dominus et unavit eum, sola gloria induit eum. Alleluia. Dominus vobiscum. Spirito tuo, sequentia sancti Evangelii secundum Matteum.
Gloria a tibi, Domine.
In illo tempore redixit Iesus discipulis suis, vigilate quae nescitis qua porre Dominus este venturus sit. Illudatem citote quoniam si celit pater familias, qua porre flu venturus estit, vigilare dutique et non sine perfudi Domum suam. Id eo et vos est toti parati, quia qua nescitis porra filius hominis venturus est. Quis putas est fidelis servus et prudens, quae constituit Dominus suus super familiam suam, ut etilis cibum in tempore? Beatus ire servus, quem veneri Dominus eius, in veneri sic facientem. Amen dico vobis, quoniam super omnia bona sua constituit enim.
Laus tibi Christi.
St. Dunstan of Canterbury, Bishop and Confessor. We also commemorate St. Pudentiana, Virgin of Rome and Martyr. The epistle today is taken from the letter of St. Paul, the beloved apostle to the Hebrews. Brethren, of other priests there was a succession, since death denied them permanence, whereas Jesus continues forever and his priestly office is unchanging. That is why he can give eternal salvation to those who, through him, make their way to God. He lives on still to make intercession on our behalf. Such was the high priest that suited our need, holy and guiltless and undefiled, not reckoned among us as sinners, lifted high above all the heavens, one who has no need to do as those other priests did, offering a twofold sacrifice day by day, first for his own sins, then for those of the people. What he has done once for all, and the offering was himself, our Lord Jesus Christ. And the Holy Gospel today is a continuation of that according to St. Matthew. At this time, Jesus told his disciples, "You must be on the watch then, since you do not know the hour of your Lord's coming. Be sure of this, if the master of the house had known at what time of night the thief was coming, he would have kept watch and not allowed his house to be broken open. And you too must stand ready. The Son of Man will come at an hour when you are not expecting him. Which of you then is a faithful and wise servant? One whom his master will entrust with the care of the household to give them their food at the appointed time. Blessed is that servant who is found doing this when his Lord comes. I promise you he will give him charge of all his goods." Hail Mary, full of grace. grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti.
Amen.
Carissimi, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast mass. As we said on this feast of St. Dunstan of Canterbury, Archbishop of Canterbury, who died, was born roughly around 909-910 AD, and died on this day in 988 AD. He was successively Abbot of Glastonbury, Bishop of Worcester, then of London, and then Archbishop of Canterbury. He served no less than four kings during his lifetime. He was, before St. Thomas Becket and before Edward the Confessor, both of whom were much after his time, St. Dunstan was the most popular of British saints, and is famously depicted with Smith's tongs for two reasons. One, he was a silversmith, and was known as a great maker of ecclesiastical plate, of church plate, so chalices and ciborio and things like that, but also because he saw off the devil one time with his tongs. He was born of a noble family of Wessex. Anyone watching the series The Last Kingdom may have more of an appreciation of the era we're talking about, around Alfred's time, and England, as we know it, is not yet a single entity. It is made up of different kingdoms. You may recall that our patron saint here, St. Wilfrid, converted Sussex, the last of the pagan kingdoms. In the time of Dunstan, there was the Kingdom of Wessex, the Kingdom of Mercia, the Kingdom of the East Angles, East Anglia to us now, the Kingdom of Kent, and the Kingdom of Sussex, the Kingdom of Northumbria. So, regional kingdoms is quite interesting, or bizarre, or perverse, that Tony Blair, as Prime Minister, reintroduced a kind of concept of these separate kingdoms again with his regional councils. So England was not one country as we know it now. And of course there were competing kingdoms. Kings were competing with each other. There also, of course, was the threat of the Vikings all this time, who themselves had conquered the north and were ruling, of course, from the Shetland Islands down through Northumbria to York. And they, of course, were pagans. It was also known, or it is known to us by historians, as the Dark Ages. We have to be careful, I think, of this term. Often many people think it means that in the Dark Ages people were not very bright, which is far from the case, but certainly life was very hard, and England, or its various kingdoms, was not particularly wealthy, and learning was something still reserved for a few. We hadn't quite yet reached the level of preponderance of monasteries or even university colleges quite yet. Dunstan was a very important figure in reviving monasticism in England, particularly Benedictine monasticism. He restored the Abbey of Glastonbury, and in his various bishoprics promoted and assisted in the revitalization of
system of schooling, which legacy we still enjoy today. Remember, people often forget because of the propaganda of the Reformation, people forget that the monasteries in this country were very important and very significant for all sorts of reasons, for local economies depended upon them. The monks, of course, were bequeathed land by people who wanted their prayers and masses said for their souls. Thus, the monks relied upon tenant farmers, who in turn relied upon serfs and peasants to do the work and to tend the fields. All this providing and generating economy, providing and generating wealth, providing and generating stability, homesteads and such. But also too, of course, the monks provided hospitality, they provided medicine, they provided schooling, so that, and for free. People often again think of medieval monasticism, but they think of high medieval monasticism. So they recall, of course, that great princes and the sons of great noblemen were often schooled at Benedictine houses, abbeys. But they forget, of course, that those schools and those monasteries educated anyone who was prepared to go to school. Often, of course, sometimes as oblates, people would give sometimes the youngest son, or they would give their boys to the monasteries, both for schooling and education, sometimes with or without the expectation that they would remain at the monastery of monks. But it was the only place for learning, to learn to read, to write, and of course perhaps later to draw. And we have those wonderful illuminated manuscripts and gospel books handed down through the ages that speak to and demonstrate to us both the level, not just of craftsmanship, of artistic work and worth, but also too the piety and devotion and dedication of those committed to passing on the faith, passing on the word of the Gospels. All of this St. Dunstan played a part in. All of this, through his efforts in his lifetime, we have enjoyed the legacy since. So let us today give thanks for the life of St. Dunstan, give thanks for his great efforts and work that have enabled us to take so much for granted, have enabled us, for example, to have our schooling and our education, to enable us to enjoy the benefits of medical centres and hospitals. And it is a great pity, and for this we ought to pray, for our, in our own time, a revival of religious life, a revival of monasticism. Wouldn't it be wonderful, again, if there were great Benedictine or other religious houses, centres for learning, centres of hospitality, centres of caring, and centres of devotion. Wouldn't it be wonderful if this country again was blessed by the prayers of monks and nuns who had given themselves devotedly to God and to service, and to serving their community, not just of their brothers and sisters, but of all the community around them. This is probably too much to hope for, and I'm not really thinking of returning us all to a medieval monastic time, but just imagine if there were centres of learning and caring and hospitality once again all over our country. And this is something we can pray for, this is something that some of us may be called to restore, and certainly this is something that all of us might try to attempt in our own way in the living of our own Christian lives,
opportunity to have answers to those questions, and in so doing spread the gospel of God's love to all. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spirito tuo.
Oremus.
Veritas mea et misericordia mea cum ipso et in nomine meo exultabitur coniueus.
Alleluia. Gloriosius benedictus. caritate, compassione nostra, ricordatus es Christus, ipse in verus es altus verbs curit peccato mundi, qui morte nostra moriendo distruxi, de vita resurgendo reverrati, et in eut evangelis et ac angelis controlis et dominationibus congoi omnis et celestis ex exegitus, in un gloria et veritatibus sine fine in genitus.
Sanctus. Sanctus. Sanctus.
Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis celi et terra gloria tua,
Hosanna in excelsis.
Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini,
Hosanna.
Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee, and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
Servus quempo veneri dominus in veneri flagilante, a mendico vobis super omnia dono suo constituit erum. Alleluia. Dominus vobiscum
et cum spirito tuo.
Alleluia. Beati Dunstan, confessoris tuiasque pontificis, quaesimus Domine, pregationi nos adjugare in cuius relationi tu continuus sacramenta. Per Dominum nostrum Jesu Christum, Filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in aeternitate Spiritus Sancti Deus. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. so Quod ad tempore cepere tempore est, quod est stat in fius Dei fiei.